What's up, YouTube? Dead Jerk here, bringing you another video. And this is the first part of my planning to go to regionals series. Not the series where I'm planning to go to regionals, but to help other people plan on regionals and whatnot. Because I think it's really important that you plan ahead. You don't just, you know. And first part, I honestly think, is choosing your deck. Obviously, most important part, I mean, not more important than finding out how you're going to get there and where you're going to stay. But, you know, once you have all that figured out, you shouldn't need my help to help you find how you're getting regionals or how you're where you're staying. But this is already a point where you're planned that you're going to regionals. Now, the deck. First, that's the first part, in my opinion. You shouldn't be playing, like, if you're watching this and you're planning on going to a regional in 3 days, well, and you don't know what you're playing, then you are not in the right place, and you are not going to be prepared for this regional. So make a deck, have fun. If you top, then wow, that's really good for you. But you should be knowing, like, what you want to play weeks before. The only regional I can go to this Duelist Alliance season, which isn't even till the next format, that is like over a month away, and I already know what I'm playing. But now let's go over the decks of the format, and decks that I think might be next format. So anyway, first is Shadal's. This deck is really good, of course. I mean, it's hard. It's so consistent. It has so much draw power. Shadal Fusion is crazy because, like, most decks want to exceed, most decks want to synchro, most decks, you know, want to go for something in the extra deck. And, like, you know, to do most of your plays or to get over our monsters, you have to. And R, I'm saying R because, yes, I plan on playing Shadal's. Personally, it's my favorite deck. It's really close between them and Satellanites, but I have Shadal's made, pretty much. My stuff's being ordered, so, it's on its way. So, I'm playing Shadal's, and I'm not going to go back and make Satellanites when Nebs are $40, and I just rather play this deck, since, just because I can. So, Shadal's really good. Consistency, they stun, but they're not as hyped and not as good as they were hyped to be. And you know, once we get our support in new challengers, it is going to be really good. I think we get the new fusion monsters, and I think we get the L Shadal fusion, which is a great card. So anyway, so the Shadal's, that's one deck that's really good this format that you could play. Another card would be Satellanites. Once again, I mentioned them while I was talking about Shadal's. This deck's just amazing. It makes rank 4 plays. Like, no tomorrow can easily in one turn make a 3 level 4 rank 4 play, which is just crazy. And then the fact you have Altair, which is, you know, it's a rare. It's a wolf bark. I mean, sure, you can only attack with Stellanites that turn, but, like, three wolf barks, which happens on summon, so that means I could be called haunted another monster on my opponent's turn. A lot of people argue with me, well, wolf bark was more OP. Yeah, well, yeah, but, you know, most time you're going to use wolf bark, in my opinion, is when you summon it, it's pretty much you use its effect, and it's either gets Veilered or Fiendished, and it doesn't, or you overlay it. You hardly ever would keep it out. Whereas this thing, I mean, same thing, but this thing is on summon, so if you call the Haunted, it gets its effect immediately on my opponent's turn. So, like, you can just abuse them all. Altair, abuse it. Deneb, abuse it. So I can search on my turn. So, like, I can call a Haunted Altair, bring Deneb, and then I can just add Altair back, so I have one for my turn. Like, it's... To me, that deck is insane, especially with Skybridge and Stellar Nova. They have to tribute a monster to negate. Whatever. And then they draw a card, so it's not that big of a setback, because they're going to get that card back. Like, once you finally get rid of all their Altairs, like, can you be safe? No. You're not safe. There's too many good cards. So, Satellanites, great deck. And Burning Abyss, I don't know. this deck's really good. I mean, the fact that they're all tour guide targets, their effects get negated, it makes tour guide really good. Tour guide's a 3. They can search tour guide. The deck's really good. They can make Pleiades. They can make like the rank of magic plays. Really good deck. Personally, this is my least favorite. To me, it's an alright deck, but they're really reliant on a lot of things. But their effects are really good because they are whenever they're sent to the graveyard by any means. It's like crazy how that works. And they search tour guide, and it's just really good. And no, of course these aren't your only 3 options. There's other options. You don't have to play tier 1 meta. And I have a couple other decks that I consider them tier 1, maybe tier 2, but they're definitely pretty close to the top decks. Which you got Prophecy, Modulshe, Evil Swarm, and Bujins. And let's talk a little bit of Prophecy. Is just great because they don't really lose hand advantage. They have Wisdom. They get a double draw every turn for a tower. So like your main plays, you really want to, like, whenever I play against Prophecy, it's like, man, how can I, like, I don't care if they have a fucking Priestess out. No, part of my language. I don't care if they have a Priestess out, but I'd rather get rid of that tower because I can get rid of that Priestess later. It sounds kind of funny, but yeah. And then Modulshe. I mean, if they can go off. If Modulshe go off, it's crazy. The Tiramisu pluses them back to their hand when you have Chateau out. And then, so, like, you just plus from your graveyard. And then you get to minus your opponent. Like, it's insane. That card's just too good. But, you know, Wind does a thing. And and then you got Evil Swarms. And then you got Bujins. Evil Swarm, just a good matchup against... it's pretty much just a good matchup against Shadals. I don't think the deck's that great, but I mean, you play the decks when you can play like 3 emptiness, which I'm not talking about being budget friendly right now. And when you can play Yamato, like, you don't have to special summon, you have Crane, you have, like, it's a really good card. I mean, it all happens at end phase, so like the effects of like Veiler and all that wear off at end phase, I believe. I'm not sure if the ruling's different on that. In my personal opinion, playing the deck, you're going to want, at the very minimal of testing, is 2 weeks. I think 2 weeks isn't even enough, but if you haven't decided 2 weeks before you're going to regional, I think 2 weeks is probably when you should decide, when the 2 weeks before your regional, so you can start testing the different build you want to play. Don't just go neck deck something. I mean, sure, you can look at other people's builds to decide what type of build you want to play, but don't go net deck it and just play it. That's just my opinion. I think when you do little things, little techs or whatever, it just makes it better for you. It helps your playstyle. Helps you grow as a player. And that's my opinion. That's pretty much what I have to say about it. Now, what do I think the best deck out of these decks are? Well, to be honest, I think right now, if you don't play Shadals, Burning Abyss, or Satellers, I said that wrong, but Burning Abyss or Satellers, you have a really good chance, because you're not really sided for as much. When you're playing Bujins, like, you're not sided for as much as, like, it's like, if I was playing Shadals, I'd probably side really, really heavy for Satellers, and if I was playing Satellers, then I would probably side really heavy for Shadals, like, because Wind is a problem. Whereas most of the side decks really are siding for these matches, rather than, you know, playing Bujin, Evil Swarm, like, they're not really preparing to play these decks, which I would consider rogue at this point in time. So I think, like, if you really if you don't have the deck, you can't make Shadals, make one of these decks. Sure, there are more. I just kind of got a few off my head, just thinking about it. But in my opinion, that since you're not going to be sided for as much, play these decks, play techs, play stuff to help you beat the tough matchups. Like in Modulshe's, you're going to want to play the Chalices to get over Winda. You're going to want to play the Fiendishes. You're going to want to play the Breakthroughs. You really want to stop their Winda. And then, like, if you can stop their Winda and you go off, like, they don't really have much of a play besides Construct. And if you, like, play your, like, Deep Prisons and stuff like that, then you're not even going to have that big of a deal. I mean, like, it's a really pretty easy matchup, even though you would think Winda is hard. And then Prophecy is just... Prophecy is pretty good. I don't know. I hate playing against the deck. I hate the deck. I don't think it should burn. Like, I think it's perfectly balanced. I just think pretty much their card I don't like it for them is Tower. But they're an amazing deck. Evil Swarm, they're just a really good rank 4 deck. Just don't play it like you're playing Ophion. Just Ophion. I mean, obviously play Ophion if you're gonna like go against your dolls. Like, that's a really good play to get Pandemic and like save your Ophion. And then Yamato, I don't even know. Bujin's just, in my opinion, have a pretty good matchup in general over top of Shaddolls. So, play this deck. The gist of the video is play your deck that you're most comfortable with, the deck that you know most. Get a good amount of testing in, and that's how you decide what deck you want to play. I mean, I've played decks at multiple regionals. You know, the best way to test a deck is to play it in a tournament form, and the bigger the tournament, the better the competition, always. In my opinion. I mean, sure, like, if I got, like, 100 scrubs, no offense, scrubs, I don't know who you guys are, but scrubs, I get 100 scrubs and go play in this tournament and beat them all, am I really gonna be a better player at the end of the day? These guys don't know the rulings, they're playing, like, freaking Force Raider and Karibo. No, I'm not, it's not gonna make me a better player, but I'm still gonna know the end. I'm still gonna learn my deck better, but I'm not gonna be able to learn what situations I get in. So really, that brings me to my next segment, which will be my next video, testing and playing and actually building a deck after deciding what deck you want to use. So I'm gonna thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys learned. Thanks. Peace.